restaurant. How long can it be?
At least 5 pages.
But can it be longer than 5 pages?
As long as you want.
It's all in my head. If only I can sort it out. Oh, well, first I have to sort it out.
Well, take your time, honey boy. I know you've had a great deal to adjust to. Just get it in by the end of the term.
Right. As soon as I get it together. No later than that. Thanks, Mrs. Simon. The place to begin. I'd gone to a movie. When I stepped out into the bright sunlight from the darkness of the Bibby house, I had only two things on my mind. Paul Newman and a ride home.
How much I look like Paul Newman? He looks tough and I don't.
The other thing, it's a long walk home with no company. But I was used to it. I usually run when I go to movies anyway. Well, I mean, I like to go to movies alone so I can get into them and live them with the actors. I'm different that way. Well, my second older brother, Soda, hardly ever cracks a book. And Derry works too hard to even think about reading a story or drawing a picture. So I'm not like it. Besides, no one in our gang digs books or movies the way I do. So I usually won't.
Hey, you greaser!
And I'm a greaser. Greasers don't walk alone too much or they get jumped by the socials. I'm not sure how you spell that, but it's the abbreviation for the word the socials, the jet set, you know, the rich kids. We're poorer than the socials, and I reckon wilder too, but not like the socials, who jump greasers and wreck houses and throw beer glass for kicks. Greasers are more like hoods. We steal things and drive old souped-up cars and get in gang fights. Well, I don't mean I do. Derry would kill me if I got into trouble with the police. You see, ever since Mom and Dad died in a car crash, the three of us get to stay together only as long as we behave. So, Derry, Soda, and I try to stay out of trouble as much as we can. Look, I'm not saying that either the socials or the greasers are better. That's just the way things are.
Hey, freeze! What you doing out here all alone, freeze? We're going to give you a pick, freeze. We're going to talk about long freeze in here.
Ain't safe to be out here all by itself.
Don't leave me alone!
You got a haircut, freeze?
No!
I'd like that haircut to be just below the chin.
Stop that!
Get it off!
Hey,
say something! He's asking to call it,
Bob!
Okay, kid.
Jerry!
Go!
And there were shouts and pounding of feet, and the socials just jumped up and left me lying there, gasping. I later wondered what in the world was going on. People were jumping over me and running by me, and I was too dazed to figure it out.
Pony Boy, you okay?
Did he cut you?
No. I'll talk.
I'm cruising on territory. Socials, come on.
You're really okay. You're not hurt.
Yeah. I'm okay. Nothing at all.
Man, they have to stop jumping us. They have to stop.
Johnny? Johnny, what's that in your hand?
It ain't anything. Never mind.
Johnny, you shouldn't be walking around with that.
I can't take another beating. Get another from my father.
Pony Boy, are you all right? Tell me!
Okay,
Derry, just take a minute. Sorry. You're never sorry, Derry. Not about anything.
The kid's okay.
You're an okay kid, Pony Boy.
Did you guys catch him?
Nope, got away this time.
Hey, cut in your throat a couple rocks. You think you like that?
You know you're out of jail, Dally.
Got off early. Good behavior.
Pony Boy, what have you been walking all night?
I was coming home from the movies. I didn't think it mattered.
You didn't think. You never think. Not at home or anywhere where it counts. Now you must think at school with all those good grades.
And you always got your nose stuck in some book. But you never use your brain for common sense.
No sorry, Bob. If you were walking that road, why weren't you carrying a blade?
No matter what I did, Derry, you wouldn't care.
I just stared at the hole in the top of my shoe. Derry and I just didn't dig each other. I never could please him. He would have yelled at me for carrying a blade if I carried one. Now if I brought home B's, Derry wanted A's. If I was playing football, I should be Reese's. If I was studying, I should be playing football. Derry never hollered at Soda, not even when Soda dropped out of school or got pulled over for speeding. He just hollered at me.
Now leave my kid brother alone here. It ain't his fault he likes to go to the movies. And it ain't his fault so slight to jump us.
And if he'd been carrying a blade, it would have been a good excuse to pay. brother to tell me what to do with my other kid brother. I'll ask him, kid brother.
Well, you know what? Next time just ask Willis to go with him. Willis will.
Hey, speaking of movies, head over to the Daily Double tomorrow night. Any of you want to come?
I'm taking Amy. Aren't you taking Sylvia?
No time. I'm working.
Me and you're always working.
I've got a choice.
Hey, Soda, how about you? I'm picking up Sandy for the game.
I'm glad you're here to stay.
Sandy! Can you stay?
No.
Things at home. Gotta go.
I've got a choice.
Hey, too big. You, Johnny and Pony want to come? It ain't a school night.
Me and Johnny will come.
Hey, Gary.
Since it ain't a school night.
If I don't get boosted up, you'll probably.
If I ever catch you getting boosted up.
Gary!
You need to boost up.
I seen you lots of times.
Come on, Sandy.
He don't need alcohol. He gets drunk on just plain living.
But I'm probably fine alcohol.
Hey, too big. If you're walking towards my place, if you're in the neighborhood, could you?
Happens I'll be going right by our place. Right by your door. Come on.
Thanks, too big. You remember how John looked when he got beat up?
Why do the soldiers hate us so much?
I'm reading this book in English, Great Expectations, and that kid Pitt, he reminds me of us. How he got marked last because he wasn't a Southern gentleman.
And how that girl treated him.
Totally good. You
know how it happened to me once. I was dissecting a worm in biology, and I didn't have a brazier, so I used my switchblade.
Homie!
Well, I wouldn't have done it if I knew it was wrong. But then this girl behind me, she turned around and said, "They're all right. You're ahead."
So? Well, was she pretty?
Well, she did look good in yellow. But don't tell her. You'll say I wasn't thinking. You
probably do look.
But would you call her?
Like hell, so you know.
I gotta get home before his mom gets hacked off. I don't want to miss the game tomorrow.
I wouldn't miss it pretty. Did you ever call?
Better than you. Have you?
Jumping in back seats, leaning in the car windows. Get in. who was in jail, who was running away. By that time, it was getting dark enough to sneak under the back fence and drive.
Come on, John. Just let that.
I don't do this guy.
Come on.
You know he has to be legal.
Boy, boy.
Sure.
You really made him mad. Jeff, Pop, and Randy are disgusting. I endorse him with the media. They need a lesson. We bikinis on Vessel Beach? Must be something by J.D. South. Stop that!
This is real. Bikinis on Muscle Beach. Wanna see some muscle? Who's gonna make me?
You better leave us alone, or I'll call the cops. That's pretty crazy this night.
You two better already said.
Leave us alone!
Yeah, I thought I'd seen you around the rodeo.
It's a shame you can't ride a bull half as good as you can talk it.
Thought you'd do barrel race.
Why don't you just be nice and leave us alone?
I'm never nice. Want a coke?
I wouldn't drink it if I were starving in the desert. Get lost! Are you going to tell us?
No.
You don't look surprised. What's your name?
I wish you hadn't asked. It's pointing white curtains.
That's an original rage.
Well, my father wasn't an original and lovely person. I've got a brother named Soda Pop, and it says so on his birth certificate.
My name's Sherry, but they call me Cherry because of my hair. Cheer it up.
I know. You're a cheerleader. We go to the same school.
How come we never see you at school?
Well, I got put up a year in grade school.
Well, what's a nice, smart kid like you running around with some trash like that for?
Dallas is a greaser. Same as me. We're buddies.
Oh, sorry, good boy. Your brother's Soda Pop. Does he work at a gas station? A DX?
Yeah.
Man, your brother is one doll.
I might have asked your brothers. You look alike. How come you're bullshit?
It's not every day I hear a good-looking associate something like that.
Hey, why come we never see him at school?
Well, he's a dropout.
Dropout made me think of some poor, dumb-looking hoodlum wandering the street, breaking out street labels. It didn't fit my happy-go-lucky brother at all. Fit Dally perfectly. But you could hardly say it about Soda.
You don't feel any good. Poor you. For the redhead and black muscles. What do you got with it?
This might pull you off.
Fire him.
Well, like you know. Leave her alone, Dallas.
What'd you say, young kid?
You heard me. Leave her alone.
Or repeat that.
Just leave her alone.
Dallas scowled for a second. If it had been me, Tubin, Soda, Steve, or anybody but John, Dally would have flattened him without a moment's hesitation. You just don't tell Dally Winston what to do. Johnny was the gang's pet, so Dally couldn't really hit him. He was kind of Dally's pet, too. Dallas just stomped off with his fist jammed in his pocket, around his face. He didn't come back.
Thanks, now I'm scared.
You sure didn't show it? Why he talks to Dallas like that?
What are star you two?
One time, a kid told Dally to move over at a candy counter, and he belted him so hard he knocked the tooth loose. You got a lot of guts, Johnny. Pony.
Y'all go in here and sit with us. You can be dead then.
Okay. Might as well.
So how old are you?
14. 16.
That's funny. I thought you were about 16.
How come you both ain't scared of us like you were with Dallas?
Well, first you didn't start in on the way we did. And then you made him leave us alone. And when we asked you to sit up here, you didn't act like it was an invitation to make out for the night.
Oh.
I heard about that Dallas Winston, and he looks mean, but not you two.
Sure, we're young and innocent.
No, not innocent. You've seen too much to be innocent. Just not dirty.
Dallas is cool. He's tough, but he's a cool old guy.
He'd leave you alone if he did.
Well, I'm glad he doesn't know this. It's funny. Way I sort of admire him.
Hey, weren't you two yelling at someone a while ago?
Yeah, our days. They brought us along with some booze. I don't like to sit in a driveway and watch someone get drunk.
You really made him mad.
I don't even care.
Okay, Grease, do that!
Boy, 2 minutes is scarce.
Yeah.
Johnny? Kid? Come on, it's all right.
Not too bad.
Who's this, your great aunts?
Great-grandmother's twice removed.
Sharp one. How could a couple of you be picked up like Polly and Johnny?
Well, see, actually, we picked them up. We're Arabian slave traders, and we're thinking of Shanghai them. They're worth 10 camels apiece.
Fine. They don't talk Arabian. Say something Arabian, Johnny.
Do we? Dallas was bothering, but when they left, they weren't as upset by him, protecting from greasers like you.
Where is old Dallas, anyways? Tim Shepard's looking for him.
Dallas is having some action.
We'll probably find a fight. He slashed the tires on Tim's car just for kids, which is no joke when you gotta work for it.
You don't get to play rough or anything.
Skin fight ain't rough. Blades rough. So are chains, and pool sticks, and heaters. He'll find Dallas, and they'll have a fighting phase up. No sweat.
Yeah, or so if he gets killed or something, you just bury him. No sweat.
You did okay, baby.
Honey, come with me. We'll get some popcorn.
Sure. Y'all want some?
You don't stay and watch the movie.
I think I've got your numbers, baby.
What numbers?
Phone numbers, school address. The girl said watch the movies, so watch it!
I think I might have some paper here somewhere.
Sherry didn't really want popcorn. She wanted to talk.
Your friend, you want to side with him? He's okay.
He ain't being like Dally, if that's what you mean.
Sure he's okay.
Johnny's been in a fashion time, hasn't he?
It wasn't social.
I don't want to watch bikinis on Boston Beach. I want to hear about this.
It was almost 4 months ago. A warmer spring day with the sun shining bright. But it was getting dark and chilly by the time we headed home. At the corner of our street, there's a wide open field where we hang out and play football. We have a rumble, and it's off on the side of a fist fight or two. We were passing in when Steve noticed something lying on the ground. Picked it up. It was Johnny's blue jean jacket. The only jacket he had.
Looked like Johnny forgot his jacket,
Steve said, slinging it over his shoulder to take it by Johnny's leg. But then he stopped and examined it more closely. There was a stain the color of rust on the collar. Steve looked at the ground. There were more stains on the grass. He looked up and across the field with a stricken expression on his face. And I think we all heard the low moan. So the dark motion was finger on the other side of the lawn at the same time. He saw him face down the grass. So he turned him over gently. And Ty nearly got sick. Someone had beaten him up bad. His white t-shirt was splattered with blood. I just stood there, trembling with sudden hope. I thought he might be dead. Steve let out a low groan, dropped to his knees beside Soda. Somehow the whole gang sensed what had happened. Jubit was suddenly there. His comical grin was gone. Dairy sauce from the porch and came running toward us. Dahlia was there too, swearing under his breath. And Dahlia had seen people killed on the Forest West side. So why did he look so sick now?
Johnny? Soda? Yeah, man, it's me. Listen, don't talk. You're gonna be okay.
There was a bunch of blue Mustang. I got scared.
Trying to swear. I had seen Johnny take a whippet with a 2x4 from his old van and never let out a whimper. It made it all the worse to see him break down. Soda just held him tight and pushed his hair out of his eyes. Finally, between sobs, Johnny got out his story. A blue Mustang with 4 soldiers in it pulled up next to the lot. They caught Johnny. One of them had a lot of wings on his hands. That's what kept Johnny up so bad. Johnny was never a coward. He was a good man in a rumble and a fight. And after that night, Johnny was jumped from the bathroom. Johnny never walked by himself after that. And Johnny, the most law-abiding nuts, now carried in his back pocket a 6-inch switchblade. And he'd use it too if he ever got jumped again. Johnny would kill the next person who jumped. Nobody was ever going to meet him up like that again. Not only his dead body.
Mustang?
Yeah. One of them had rings on his hand. What cut him up so bad?
All soldiers aren't like that.
Sure.
That's like saying all greasers are like Dallas Winston. I'll bet he's jumping through people.
Well, philosophy.
You think the soldiers have it made, don't you?
You do.
You know, it may come as a surprise, but we have trouble you've never even heard of. You know something? Things are tough all over.
Then why are we so different?
You're more emotional. We're sophisticated. Cool to the point of not even feeling anything. I catch myself talking and realize I don't mean half of what I'm saying. I mean, I don't really think a beer blast like a river bottle is super cool, but I'll rave about it just to have something to say. I never told that to the first person. Why is that?
Probably because I'm in Greece and I'm younger, so you don't have to keep your guard up.
For a kid, you're awful smart.
Probably I'm growing. We better get home.
You read a lot, don't you?
Yeah, why?
I can just tell. I bet you our son does too. Yeah. I used to watch before I got so busy.
You eat all the popcorn.
Yeah, well this is a social of blue mustache and the rings on his hand.
Better you got a closer look.
Rest of you. Back off, guys.
You greasers need to pick up our girls. Our girls!
Right in territory. Better watch it.
Next time, pick up your own kind of dirt.
Listen, greasers, we got four more in the back seat.
Then pick the back seat.
You're looking for a fight.
You mean if I'm looking for a real good jump? You got nervous, so you give it to us?
Hey! Okay, kid, you want a real performance?
Come on!
He touched that kid and I'll call the cops!
Hold it a minute.
You what?
I said I'll call the cops. We have one fight, so we'll go with you. But first you go wait in the car.
Wait?
I'll be along in a minute. Just go wait in the car.
See?
We ain't scared of him.
Too dangerous.
The way things are, man.
We couldn't even let our parents see us. Let's not push the 1 minute rule. It's fine. Hope I never see a thousand friends again.
Because he's one of us?
No, he might fall in love with him. Now that means a job.
Man, Marshall's bold. Must have been out of my mind, you bastard. But I told you anyways. I think we'll go play a little snooker and have a poker game. I don't know. Those two girls are tough, though.
Yeah, but too big. They see us at school. You can't even say hi.
If that's your worst problem.
Yeah, I guess.
Johnny and I stretched out on our mats. It was a cold night, and I was I would look at stars in sub-zero weather. And I must think tough. Big-time socials, all right. I felt the nervous tension growing inside me. A bitterness. I knew I wasn't fair for the socials to have everything. It wasn't our fault we were greasers. I couldn't just take or leave it like Tubit, or love life anyway like soda, or harden myself beyond caring like Dallas, or even actually enjoy it like Tim Shepard. I felt the tension growing inside of me, and I knew if something didn't happen, I was going to explode.
Man, we could have hurt their reputation. We could have gotten a fight, Johnny. We could have done okay. You don't understand. I'd rather kill myself or something. I don't want to fight. Don't talk like that, Johnny. You don't mean it. I don't know. Maybe I'll sleep here tonight. By the fountain. Pretend it's a waterfall or someplace in the country. Probably someplace without greasers and socials. Someplace with just people. We have the whole family. Drive out of the kitchen. Let me tell you something crazy. Some of the time I think I like it better when the old man's hitting me. I mean, at least he knows I'm there. I walk in, nobody notices. I walk out, nobody notices. I stay out all night, nobody cares. At least you got soda, I ain't got nobody. Shoot, Johnny, you got the whole game, man. It ain't the same.
Johnny went to sleep right away, since I was asleep too. Dream. I brought Mom and Dad back to life. Mom and bake things. Dad would drive out early to pick up a truck to feed the cat. Mom was golden and beautiful. When I woke up, I thought, glory, what time is it? Just thinking about facing Derry this late made me shake. I ran home as fast as I could. I got close. I could see.
Mom and Dad are asleep.
Pony boy, do you know what time it is?
Well, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, kiddo.
Another hour, we would have the cops out after you. Where have you been? Where in the almighty universe have you been?
I was sleeping a lot, Jerry.
You what?
Say, Pony, where you been?
I just fell asleep.
It never occurred to you that your brothers might be wearing their heads off and afraid to call the cops and get you thrown in the boys' home so quick it made your head spin, and you were asleep in the lot?
Well,
Jerry, I said I didn't mean to, okay? I'm sorry. I forgot. That's all I hear from you. Can you speak of anything?
Hey, come on, man.
You keep your mouth shut. I'm sick and tired.
Look at me. Let me go.
Pony boy.
I didn't mean to. First thought. I remember thinking, I'll find Johnny and run away. I remember thinking, at least things can't get worse. I was wrong. At the corner of our street, there's a wide open field. Down in the middle, about 2 Fox Square. At 2:30 in the morning, it's a nice place to cool off. It was kind of cold. I think if I got any colder, I'd turn into a popsicle.
Can you have to freeze to death, Pony?
You ain't a woman. I started to say something when a sudden blast from a cargo made us both jump. It was the blue Mustang. It was circling the block slowly.
I bet they're after us. We were walking with the girls. It's the social. What are they doing this far? It's our territory. You came back to the girls, remember? Correct. This is all I need to top off the perfect night.
John? Why am I for?
Too late, they're already here. Some socials were coming straight at us, and from the way they were staggering, I figured they were really drunk. That scared me. I wish desperately that someone in Derek should have been there. The four of us could have handled them easy. But I knew it would just have to be me and John. It was Randy and Bob, and some other socials. I knew they recognized us. And I knew that Johnny realized who they were, too. Because I watched him watch the sunlight glint off of Bob's rings.
Gee!
Let me go! Take the hot! I'm a child! Quit your drown!
This time he's paid now!
Help, Johnny! Help! Help!
Mustang!
Get out of here, Helmet!
I lay there, coughing and gasping. I lay there weakly, and when I finally sat up, Johnny was sitting right by me, one hand on his knee, staring straight ahead.
Johnny, what happened? They were drowning you. So
I think I'm going to be sick.
Oh, I think I already was.
How could you do this, Johnny? How could you do it?
They were going to kill you.
Johnny, look, man. They put you in the electric chair for killing people. What are we going to do?
I don't know.
First thing, keep your mouth shut.
Yeah.
For the social cruise in our territory.
They were herding ponies.
Yeah, I see. First thing you need is plans, you need money. There ain't someone to know about this. Holy cow, I ain't itching to be the one to tell Derek.
Don't tell him, Dally, please.
Here, put this on. Dying the money before the cops get you. It's $50 in the pocket.
What are we gonna do?
Take the 315 freight from Wintersville. Go to the top of J Hill. There's an abandoned church with a pump in the back. So don't worry about water. Take that money and buy a supply of food first thing before the word gets out. Keep going.
Thanks, Dad.
Well, I thought New York was the place I get mixed up in a murder rap.
A murder rap?
So get going.
I can't stay at home anymore. I've got to get out right now.
should call.
So, Pa, I'm going to Tallahassee, Florida. My grandmother's there. I'm going to live with my grandmother in Florida.
You don't have to go to Florida. You heard Gary. You can stay here.
I can't stay here.
We could get married. We're going to someday, so why not?
We're 16.
A couple weeks, I'll be 17.
Big difference.
I'm standing up.
I'm sorry, but I've got to get out. I can't talk about it anymore. And I can't see you anymore.
What?
That's what I came by to tell you. Things are hard enough, Sir Pop.
But
please, don't make it worse. Don't do that.
Okay. Okay for now. It's been a bad night. Have to back off a while, okay? But you know what? Keep in touch. Give it a little time to work things out.
Let me see how you are, John. Explain it to him. I sure do love you.
Looks like another fight over the lot.
Goodbye.
All right. Be right back.
Two bits over there.
Dallas is with me. They sure got great time. What am I saying? She has to visit her grandparents.
You okay?
Why not? Say, tell me I can choke this morning. Hey, soldiers are a big tits this morning.
Yeah,
tits. Heard you told the buzz that Johnny and Pony were down in Texas. That could be one possibility. Could you think of another? Yeah, chicken and corn. Corn and stingray.
Red.
They got your girlfriend. Let's run around here and you can touch her, Dallas. What since you coming on? Just like Johnny gave?
How's Johnny?
You wouldn't know about that.
What did you know about Pony Boy? You
wouldn't know about that either. Like to stay?
The reason I came home, the whole mess, maybe it's my fault.
What about it?
So maybe I can help.
You? Come on, Dallas.
Maybe we go down to that dingo and have a drink. Talk about this and that.
Don't mean Pony Boy needs somebody to testify for that you want to go make out at the dingo? I don't think so. I have to get out.
No, wait, please.
For what?
It took a lot of testing for Morgan.
Hey, any message for the juvenile delinquents?
Yeah. Tell them I said hi.
Dallas?
Just want to talk to her.
Talk nice. You hear me?
Always nice. Tell them I said hi. I heard they were from Texas.
Your kid brother's so smart. I can't find a telephone.
I've been in church before, but this is falling down on the place gave me a creepy feeling. What do you call it? Premonition.
Hey, we're loaded up. Got a week's supply of mommy, loaf of bread, candy bars, chips.
Gold with the wind. That's my favorite one. How'd you know I always wanted it?
I remembered you saying something about it once. Thought maybe you could read it. Wow, so time for something, you know?
Thanks, Johnny.
We're in big trouble, aren't we?
It was last night. And last night we were walking Sherry and Marshall over two bits. Last night I killed Bob. I could have been over 17 or 18 and I killed him. Last night, we were laying in a lot. Up in the stones. Man, I'm tired too. The next few hours were the longest. We passed time playing poker and reading down with the band. Johnny was especially stuck on the Southern General. I bet they were cool old guys, riding the battles as they were gambling. They remind me of Dallas. Dallas isn't even meaner than I am. And he's
saw how we treated those girls in the night ago.
Yeah, but one night I saw Dallas getting picked up by the buzz. Something too big did, and he knew it. But he took the stakes without batting an eye. Now that's down. He should be wrong now. Man, let's get back. Until the next morning. All the lower valley was covered with mist. The clouds changed from gray to pink, and the mist was touched with gold. There was a silent moment when everything held its breath. And the sun rose. Golly! Man, that's sure pretty. Hey, wouldn't it be cool to be able to paint that sky? Too bad it can't stay like that. Nothing gold can stay. What? Just a poem. I was remembering. Nature's first green is gold, the hardest hue of old. Her early leaves of flower, and only sowing out. And then it goes on.
Oh, you go on.
Then leaf subsides to leaf, and the meaning sank to grief. Then dawn goes down to dead, letting go to stay.
Where'd you learn that?
Robert Foster. I think he meant more to it than I did, you know.
How can you remember it?
I kept trying to figure it out. I never quite got what he meant by it. I never noticed the clouds and the sky and all that stuff until you started reminding me about it. It's like they were never there.
Johnny, I couldn't talk about things like this around anyone else except you.
Except maybe sometimes so but possibly Jerry Mounds. I guess we're different.
Shoot, Johnny. Maybe they are.
I was so tired of eating bologna, I got sick of looking at it. But we'd eaten all the candy bars, and I was dying for a Pepsi. And by that time, we ran up to Sherman's Siege of Atlanta. And I kind of owed Johnny $150 for playing poker. I was beginning to think I'd always lived in a church. Or during the Civil War.
Pony, hear it?
Who do you think it is?
I don't know.
Glory, look at the church of mine.
Dallas!
Hey, Pony, and Chuck.
Never thought I'd be glad to see Dallas.
What's happening?
I sort of dare, right? How about some buzz after?
Hey, hold on. I finished there with you once. You guys made me eat. Yeah, let's get breakfast. I'm starving.
Well, if you like some bologna, you're not going to
hang. No thanks. Buzz will be looking for you right here. Kind of lit up when you went someplace else. Someplace, down south.
Why down south?
I get hauled in for everything that happens on our turf. Kind of let drunk when you went down to Texas. They beat it out of me.
Like I told you, count.
So you guys, want to get something to eat? We got Bucks Fever down the road.
You better believe it. He's great to get the car again. Dallas always did like to drive fast, as if it didn't matter whether he got where he was going or not. But we came down that red dirt road so fast, Jimmy and I turned a little green. First we stopped in Gary. First thing I got was a Pepsi. Then we started
a dart of bananas. What next? So, Dally, I guess it's time he tells what's going on.
Yeah. Now let's, pretty much all out of warfare all over the city, you know? So what you get to Greece? You can't walk alone at night anymore. Start carrying a heater.
Dally!
You kill people with heaters.
And you kill people with switchblades too, don't you, kid?
Dallas, please.
Look, Dally, if you walk around with a gun, it's just gonna lead you to trouble.
Hey, it ain't loaded! Just helps in the bluff.
You got to help you.
We had a war canceled. You got us a spy. A soldier. Cherry, what's her name?
Cherry? The soldier?
Man, next time I pick up a problem, be my homecoming.
Very good. That's the kind of advice to be soldier.
Well, she said she'd come in and testify if you was done to turn yourselves in.
Man, that really helped.
What do you guys do better for entertainment in the country? Play checkers.
We're gonna turn
ourselves in.
What?
I got a good chance of being let off easy.
Man, you don't know what goes on down there. Greasers get a worse ball.
Well, it ain't forever pony to have to stay cooped up in a church with Derry and sort of worrying about him all the time.
Sure you want to go back?
Did my parents ask about me?
No. Hey, the game's worried to see about you. Tube it all the way down to Texas looking for you.
They didn't call or anything?
Listen. See, my old man, you don't care whether I'm broken or gutted. We're in jail for the night. That don't matter to me.
Look, guys. We'll be better to get back to the church. Let's book that.
This would have made things a heck of a lot simpler if you turned yourselves in soon.
I was scared. I still am.
Listen, gentlemen. I ain't mad at you. She said, you spent 3 months in jail. Man, you get beat.
Dally never talked like that. Dally didn't give a yank a dime about anybody but himself. He was cold and hard and mean. He never talked about his past that way, or jail. And if he did talk about jail at all, it was to Brad. Suddenly I thought of Dally. In jail at the age of 10. Dally, going around the streets. But I never finished that thought. We got to the top of the hill. Dally slammed on the brakes. Couldn't believe what we were seeing.
Lord, the church is on fire.
Come on, Dally, let's go. People over there.
I mean, a car.
What's happening?
We don't know. We're having so much. It's only the place is burning. Here's some matches.
Our matches, Tommy.
Stand back, children. Light the firemen. Some of the children are missing.
Come on, we'll go get them. Something like that again. It's all right.
Look, Dally.
brothers.
That's what they said.
But how do they know?
You have a phone number in your wallet.
Pony! Soda! Oh, man, where you been? Soda, is here to take our bus? Why did you call?
Pony boy?
Derry! Oh, man,
I thought we lost mom and dad.
Derry, I'm sorry, man. I didn't mean to.
That was a silent fear then, of losing another person he loved. I remember how close he and dad had been, and I wondered how I could have ever thought him to be cold and hard and uncaring. I listened to his heart pound through his t-shirt and knew that everything was going to be all right. I'd taken a long road around, but I was finally home to stay.
You don't look like you got much sleep this week.
I probably slept at all.
You did good week.
Doctor, we're taking our kid brother home.
He'll be fine. There's no pain.
You know, we asked about Tony and Dallas, and no one would tell us anything.
Are you members of the family?
I'll only talk with the parents.
Tony and Dallas don't have any family, except us.
We're about as much family as they've got.
Well, all right. Dallas, well, he'll be okay after he turns 2 days in the hospital. He hasn't broken up. Whatever game you say.
Dallas always okay.
What about John?
We already told his parents.
Tell it to us straight, Doctor. Johnny Payne is critical. Severe shock. He has 33 murders. It's bad.
Well, what are you doing for him?
Everything we can. But since his back is broken, can't feel anything go over the waist. Even if he lives.
Yeah? What do you mean, yeah?
If he lives, he'll be a cripple.
I thought I must be dreaming. I'd wake up at home or in the church, and everyone would be like they used to be. Even if he lives, he'll be a cripple for life, and never be able to play football or help us in a rumble again. You'd have to stay in that house in Haiti. Stay there where he wasn't wanted. Things would never be the same again.
Is he conscious?
Yeah, he's in and out.
Can we see him, though?
All right, what you guys do? Go home and get some rest.
But if he lives, Doctor.
Dr. Morris, pick up line 4, please.
You guys wanted strength, so I gave you strength.
That's right, Doctor.
Dr. Morris, pick up line 4, please.
You guys can call back to the health nurse station on this floor. They'll tell you the changes.
Thank you,
Doctor. Let's go, guys. We can't do anything else here.
This boy in my throat. Doctor gave it to us straight away.
I kept trying to convince myself I was dreaming. I would wake up and everything would be all right. Except it was getting harder and harder to convince myself. Next morning, Tubit came over, same as usual, on the earth.
You can't even believe a thing that put in your space. Who played two Grease Brothers like you and told me Johnny would be heroes?
Let's talk to you, boy.
Too good with it, Daddy. It's the individual.
I'm not going to show it alone. I'm sick of all this. No matter what you think, Bob was a good guy. He had a problem, but he was a real person.
How could I have known that?
You could. Well, I was dead. His mother had a pill.
Who's the blame?
All I know, they spoiled it. They gave in to it all the time. You kept trying to make someone say no, but they never did. One time he came home, drunk to death, falling down disgusted. And you know what they did? They said it was their fault, that they failed him. Maybe his father would give him a belt instead and still be alive. The only person who ever told Bob no was Cherry Valens. No wonder he's so crazy about it.
Look, man, I've got to get going.
That kid, your buddy, he might die.
Yeah, he might.
And tonight, people get hurt in those, maybe even killed. And it doesn't do any good. Even if you win, you'll still be greasers, you will still be soldiers. You'll still be in the bottom, you'll still be lucky with all the rings. Sick, Lois. Hey, yeah.
Look, Randy, run away ain't gonna help a thing.
Look, if I chicken, if I put that on the rumble, I'll be marked a chicken. And if I don't, I couldn't live with this. So what can I do?
Look, Randy, I'd really help you if I could.
No, you wouldn't. I'm a social. Give a little money to the whole world.
No, you hate the world. Look, I've got to get going.
Thanks, Chris. I didn't mean that. I mean, thanks.
Thanks, plenty. It was nice talking.
No matter what, we're going to clean out our territory.
Tell her to leave me alone.
I was afraid of something. You're going to have to leave.
Yeah, I'll be back, Joe.
Yeah, Sherry. The last time I saw Bob, he was drowning me.
Think hard, honey boy. When was the last time you saw Bob?
Last time I saw Bob, he was on the ground.
Don't go to the room tonight.
They bring him late?
No, they put your way. Fair deal, no weapons. Oh. I told Derek.
So I guess you're supposed to be grateful, huh?
I'm not looking for gratitude.
Why, sure, Sherry, if I could.
I have to testify to Sherry. Rainy, too.
Is there a Bible your name?
We'll be there. Find out.
Look, I've got to be there.
Sure.
Sherry, can you see the sunset pretty good for your size now?
Really?
I can see it good for Mark's night, too.
Thanks, little boy.
One of those who enjoy being a greaser. He had a tough, hard look to him. He stood there and waited to shake hands with each one of us. As he got down the line and got to me, he studied, maybe remembering how his kid brother and I played chicken. You're the quiet one. You're the one that killed the soldier?
Yeah.
Good going, kid. Curly always said you're a good kid. Curly's in reform for the next 6 months. Got copyrighted to a liquor store, jerk. Surveyed the scene with pride. I was the youngest one there. And And although Derry realized this, and he was worried, he was also proud too.
Hey, Curtis, which one?
The big one.
I went back to stand with Soda 2-bit with Steve. The soldiers were riding right on top. They all looked like they were cut out of the same piece of cloth. From the way they were dressed, they could have just as easily been going through the movies. You see, that's why people don't ever think to blame the soldiers. People usually go by looks. They lined up, silently facing us, and we lined up facing him. I looked for Randy, but I didn't see him. I kind of hoped he wouldn't be.
Man, what happened to you? You look good. You feel all right?
I've got a headache. But I'll be okay. Thank you much for asking.
Man, you go ahead and tell Derry.
I'll be okay, all right?
You think you get away with murder living with him, don't you? You're wrong. Derry's stricter with you than other folks.
Most folks are raised on kids. Derry has. Hey, boy, you don't look so good. You're all tits. I'll be okay. Grab a bottle of liquor. You get the Jameson's call. I'll be sorry.
It's getting to be that time. Is everybody happy? I am a greaser. I am the J.D. in the hood. I black the name of our fair city. Get me hits, white trash. I'm a Greeks. I'm a Sox. I'm the prunes and the well-dressed. I drive fancy cars with red windows and fancy parties.
And what do we do for fun?
We jump greasers!
Let's get the rules straight. Nothing but this, and the first one to run loses.
I'll take on anyone. Hello, Daryl.
Hello, Paul.
What's up?
Paul Holden. I'm the best bat on your football team in high school.
That soldier?
They used to buddy around. He's got to be a junior college by now.
Yeah, and Derry better work.
I'll take anyone.
Think you can handle me, Walt? I can handle anything.
Made me think of a book by Jack London. You know, the one where the wolf pack waits for one of the members to go down in a fight? Except it's different here. The moment either one swings, the rumble is on.
You guys better come meet Dallas!
Come on, come on!
Not because we've got it. It's because you're Yes. Call security. And go on.
John, that was Polly. Hey, woman, you think this looks for good to rap?
They have findings no good.
Still recognize me, Dave, but you better let your old stuff. John, don't die on me. And this is what you get for helping me with your problem. This is what you get. Man, that was crazy for not wanting to give me like me.
Callie ran out all crazy. Couldn't take it.
One a hero, and the other a hoodlum. But I remember Dally pulling Johnny from the burning church. Dally giving Johnny a gun, even though it went to jail for it. Dally saving Johnny's life. Now, he was dead. Dally didn't die of evil. He died of hood. Just like we all knew he would someday.
Easy, bud. Easy. There's nothing we can do for him anymore.
My stomach gave a violent start. It then turned to a hunk of ice. The whole world was spinning around me. Everything was one big swirling mass of color.
Johnny left you this time to run away. Say, what did you have?
I can never finish it. You never get past that part with a southern gentleman co riding into sure death with your gal.
Get some rest.
The hearing was the day after. Jerry really surprised me. Yes, ma'am. What's the theme supposed to be on?
Anything you think of works. I want your own ideas, your experience. At least 5 pages.
Like my first trip to the zoo?
If you think it's important.
Well, I was not
important. What is your important?
Schoolwork. Why else would I couldn't drop out?
In third grade, we can get you a scholarship. We can put you all the way through college.
Look, sort of dropped out. He's doing okay.
Look, Johnny and Dallas were our buddies, but you don't quit living just because they do. You don't quit.
Gary, but you can just lay off.
Look, anytime you don't like the way I'm running things right here, you can just leave.
Don't worry. You guys, why can't you?
What's with soda?
You've all seen me, too.
Hey, well, she's in Florida with her grandmother. They're riding each other. She'll be back soon.
Came back in the mail today. It's postmarked return to sender. Never been over.
I didn't even know.
Sorry.
Look, sorry. We're sorry too.
Tell me the truth, Pony. I dropped out because I'm dumb. Look,
gas station of cars. You never would have to do that. Got to understand about Eric, too. He wants you to have the chance that he missed. Look, you can't act off each other anymore. We're all we got. If you don't stay together, you don't have anything. Only you make it. You make it for all three of us.
Say, Tony.
Dad, I got some work to do.
All right. You'll think so. See you later.
Teacher,
Mr. Song.
Only one curtain.
Tell Dallas.
But it was too late to tell Dad. Suddenly it wasn't only a personal thing. I could pick.
Ha ha ha!